Hi friends, now we are solving the problems on triple integral. This topic was chosen from multiple integrals. First, they are given, evaluate integral 1 to 3, 1 by x to 1, 0 to square root of xy. Here integrand is x, y, z, dz, dy, dx. And second problem also you observe, limits 0 to 1, 0 to root of 1 minus x square and 0 to root of 1 minus x square minus y square. Integrand is x, y, z only. Coming to the third problem, 0 to 1 and y square to 1, 0 to 1 minus x. Integrand is x, dz, dx, dy. Here you have to observe one thing. Integrand is the functions of three variables. Functions of three variables. Those are x, y, z. So you require to find the limits of x, y, z. Here we discussed in a previous, remember that in the previous video, we have discussed both, x, y, z. Three limits are x, y, z are independent. That is, x is from 0 to a, y is from 0 to a, z is from 0 to a. Nothing but here, not depend on any variables. That is a modal one, okay, type one. Now, in this case, you observe, one limit is 1 to 3. Another limit, 1 by x to 1. Nothing but here, f1 of x to f2 of x. Here, you have x, y. So, this is f1 of x comma y to f2 of x comma y. So, here, the function is dependent on two variable. Here function is dependent on one variable and it is independent. So the limits of x, y, z are not independent. Coming to the second problem, 0 to 1 independent, 0 to root of 1 minus x square. So this limit is dependent on one variable, 0 to square root of 1 minus x square minus y square. So it is dependent on two variables. Next, third problem, 0 to 1, y square to 1. So here this is the independent limit and here dependent on y and here dependent on x. So first, what we have to do means we need to find out x limit, y limit, z limit. If which variable is dependent on more than one variable, which function is suppose x limit is dependent on two variables, then first we have to integrate with respect to x. If y limit is dependent on two variables, then you have to differentiate with respect to y first. That is the important one. Now you observe, first problem I am solving. The first problem is I have written. Now you see, limits I want to find, x limit, y limit, z limit. X limit, y limit, z limit I want to know. Here you observe, this is a function of x y, 2 you have, so remaining term x y you remove, then the remaining term what you have, z, remaining variable is z. So this is a function of z, is it clear? So now z is over, remaining what you have, x, y variables only, means you need to find out x limit, y limit. Now, what is the function you have? 1 by x. 1 by x is a function of x. So, you remove this one because x is not a function of x alone. So, x is a function of other variables only. Maybe that is y or z. But x is not a function of x. So, you remove this x. Now, which limit is this one? Y limit. So, you can say this is a y limit. And remaining what you have term? Here z is completed, y is also completed, remaining is x. So these are limits for x. I'll repeat again how you will identify the given function limits x, y, z. First of all, given limits you observe root x, y. Here we need to find x limit, y limit, z limit. It is a function of x, y. So remove x, y. Then obviously z is equal to root x, y. Is it clear? So z is completed now. Z over. Remaining what you have? X, y, right down. Now, and limits what you have, you see, one is 1 by x, another one is 1. So, 1 is a constant only. Now, it is a function of x. Function of x, so, you can't say this is, you can say x is equal to x, x is equal to 1 by x, no. So, it is a, obviously 1 by x is a function of x, no? So, function of x is nothing but it is limit for either y or z. Already z limit we know. So obviously this is function of what? Y. So y is equal to 1 by x. Now here you know the z limit, y limit. The remaining variable what you have? X. So x limits are what you have? 1, 2, 3. Is it clear how to find, how to identify the limits? Now we will solve the problem. So z is a function of two variables. So first we have to integrate with respect to z. Sometimes may they will give dx, dy, dz also. Okay, now that is the reason only we have to identify which limit is. This is x limit or y limit or z limit, right? Suppose here z limit is having more than one independent variable. So we are integrating with respect to z. Now integration 1, 2, 3, integral 1 by x to 1. Now x, y is a constant while integrating with respect to z. So z integration is z square by 2, limits from square root of 0 to square root of x, y. into dx dy. So integral from 1 to 3, integral from 1 by x to 1 xy, here 1 by 2 you can write outside. Now upper limit minus lower limit, z square and root getting cancelled. In place of z I have to write root xy, so root 2 square getting cancelled, then I have xy, xy minus 0 is 0 into dx minus dy, xy minus 0 I have written. Now 1 by 2 integral from 1 to 3 integral from 1 by x to 1 xy, this is xy minus 0 is xy only, so xy into xy means x square y square dx dy. Now which variable is the dependent variable? So here y is dependent on x, so first we have to integrate with respect to what? Y. So 1 by 2 times of integral 1 2 3 x square, you have to keep like this only. So y square integration, what you have? Y cube by 3, y cube by 3 limits from 1 by x to 1 into dx. So 1 by 2 is 1 by 2, integral from 1 to 3, 1 by 3 I can write outside, 1 by 3 into 1 by 2 is nothing but 1 by 6 x square. Now upper limit if you are substituted, y cube means 1 cube, 1 cube is nothing but 1 minus here y cube in place of y you have to write 1 by x, no? So 1 by x whole cube is 1 by x cube into dx. Inside x square is there, bracket is a function of x and outside also function of x is there. So integrand total it is a function of x, so I can multiply x square inside, then I will have integral 1 to 2 x square minus 1 by x dx. Now 1 by 6 times of this is equal to, you observe I am writing here 1 by 6 times of x square integration is x cube by 3, x square integration is x cube by 3 minus 1 by x integration, you observe denominator derivative in the numerator, so f dash of x by f of x dx integration formula type, so log of f of x, so denominator what I have? X, so log mod x or generally x you can write here, limits from 1 to 2, so 1 by 6 times of, if you are a substituted upper limit, then 2 cube, 2 cube means here this is limits from where to where? 1 to 3, sorry this is 1 to 3, here 1 to 3 means 3 cube, 27, 27 by 3 means here 9 minus log 3, upper limit over minus lower limit, 1 cube means 1 by 3 minus log 1, log 1 is how much? 0, so if you simplify this, 1 by 6, 9 minus log 3 minus 1 by 3 plus 0, again here you can get LCM is 3 or else here you simplify this, 1 by 6 times of, you observe this is 3 9s are 27 minus 1, 26 by 3 minus log 3, you multiply it inside 1 by here if you multiply it inside 2 3s are 6, so this is 13 by here 3 3s are 9, 13 by 9 minus 1 by 6 times of log 3, this is the answer. Okay, no need to write log 3 value and simplification. Okay, are you understood how to solve this one? First what we have to do here, we have to verify which variable is having a dependent on more than one function. First we have to differentiate with respect to that term, later on for one variable, later on independent variable. Now coming to the second problem. Given problem is integral 0 to 1, integral 0 to square root of 1 minus x square, integral 0 to square root of 1 minus x square minus y square. You observe it is a function of xy. Function of xy means obviously this is a function limits for z. So z limits we know. Now the remaining how many limits we need to find? Xy. 2 only na? That is those are xy. Now it is a function of x. So function of x is not a limit for x na? So obviously this is a limit for y. Now x is y, z is over, y is over. So the remaining is limits for x. So is it clear now which is the limit for x, y, z is? Okay, now z is the variable, z is having dependent on two variables here, x, y. So what you can say now, we have to integrate with respect to what? Z first, later with respect to y, and then with respect to x. Clear? Now I am solving the problem, integral 0 to 1, integral 0 to square root of 1 minus x square. Now xy is xy, z integration is z square by 2, limits from 0 to square root of 1 minus x square minus y square into dy dx. So 1 by 2 I can take outside, then I will get 1 by 2 integral from 0 to 1, 1 by 2 times of integral 0 to 1, integral 0 to square root of 1 minus x square. Now we are upper limit minus lower limit na? So xy first, if you are substituted upper limit, then z square, so square and root will be getting cancelled, in place of z we need to write 1 minus x square minus y square minus lower limit is 0 into dy dx. Here this is, you observe 1 by 2 times half integral 0 to 1 integral 0 to square root of 1 minus x square xy times half 1 minus x square minus y square into dy dx. Friends, here you observe xy is nothing but it is a function of both x and y, and 1 minus x square minus y square is also a function of x, y only. So, but here we have to integrate with respect to what? Y. While integrating with respect to y, we have to treat other variables as a constant. Na? But it is a function of y. Here also function of y only. So, integral uv rule. U v dx is equal to u v1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3. Leibniz rule you have. Na? So, that rule we will apply in this case. Now, here product of two functions we have. Now you observe, we have to integrate with respect to y now first. So, x terms you have to separate. This is, I am writing like integral 0 to square root of 1 minus x square. This is dy into dx. Now you observe, here outside and inside means two functions we have. What about this bracket derivative with respect to y? Bracket derivative y square derivative is what we have? 2y. 2y is there here? Of course, minus 2y you required. Is minus 2y is outside? No. So, what you have to do means multiply with the minus 2 and divide with the minus 2. Then in this case, minus 2 I am dividing. Then already 2 you have. So, it will become 1 by 4 integral from 0 to 1 x into integral 0 to square root of 1 minus x square. This is minus 2y into 1 minus x square minus y square into dy into dx. Now, bracket derivative is beside. Na? So, we have a formula. Integral f dash of x into f of x power n dx is equal to power plus 1 by power plus 1 you have or not? Power plus 1 by power plus 1. That is f of x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Right. Now, minus 1 by 4 times of integral 0 to 1. X is x here. Now, this is 1 minus x square minus y square. Power plus 1 means by 2 by here you have 2 only. That's it. Limits from 0 to square root of 1 minus x square into dx. Now you have to substitute upper limit, that is square root of 1 minus x square in this case. So minus 1 by 4 integral 0 to 1. Here 2 you can take outside, then minus 1 by 8 you will have x into, if you are substituted upper limit in place of y we need to write, you see 1 minus x square minus this square and root getting cancelled, then you will have 1 minus x square whole square. Upper limit is over minus lower limit, you see. Lower limit means here if you put y is equal to 0, then 1 minus x square whole square. Whole square only. 2 you written outside. No? That's it. Okay. Now into dx. You observe plus 1 minus x square minus 1 minus x square getting cancelled. No? This is minus 1 by 8 times half integral 0 to 1 x into. This is minus you have, you see. So minus can I write outside. Minus half minus it will become plus 1 minus x square whole square into dx. Now we have to split this one and you multiply inside. Then we will do the integration. This is equal to integral 1 x into what about a minus b whole square? A square plus b square minus 2ab na, so 2x square into dx. Now you multiply x inside, then integral 0 to 1. If you multiply x inside, x into 1 x plus x power 4 into 1 means x power 5 minus 2x cube into dx. Now integrate with respect to x, then what you will get here? X integration x square by 2 plus x power 5 integration x power 6 by 6 minus 2 x power 4 by 4. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4 here. Numerator and denominator getting cancelled. Now, if you are substituted upper limit, then you will have 1 by 2 plus 1 by 6 so minus 1 by 2. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 6 minus 1 by 2. Okay, this is upper limit. Minus lower limit means 0 plus 0 minus 0. 0 plus 0 minus 0. Nothing but only 0 na. So what is this plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 getting cancelled. Then you will have 1 by 6. But here previously we have the coefficient of this is 1 by 8. So this is 1 by 8. 1 by 8. 1 by 8 times. Then 1 by 8 times total. You will have 1 by 48 is the solution for integral 0 to 1. Integral 0 to square root of 1 minus x square, integral 0 to square root of 1 minus x square minus y square, integrand is xyz dx dy dz is equal to 1 by 48. Okay, now is it clear for everyone? Next, coming to the third problem. Given problem is evaluate integral 0 to 1 y square to 1 0 to 1 minus x, integrand is x dz dx dy. Here you observe this is independent limit and it is a function of y and it is a function of x. Here both the variables here functions are single variable only. So you cannot justify x limit and y limit or z limit this one general separately. But what you can observe with respect to integration z first or y or x, how you can identify means here you have first dz. So first you integrate with respect to z and then with respect to x and finally you have to integrate with respect to y. So integral 0 to 1, integral y square to 1. Now x is with respect to z we are doing, so x is independent of z na? So keep x as a x only. Now x into 1 you can say 1 dz is nothing but z, limits from 0 to 1 minus x into dx dy. Now integral 0 to 1 y square to 1 x into upper limit means 1 minus x minus lower limit means 0, so no need to write, into dx dy. So this is equal to, sorry, here I am writing integral 0 to 1 integral y square to 1 multiply instead x into 1 is x minus x square into dx dy. Now this is a function of x alone, so integrate with respect to x, integral 0 to 1, here you have a first dx only, now that is y. Now x integration x square by 2 minus x square integration x cube by 3, limits from y square to 1 into dy. So if you are substituted upper limit first, this is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 times minus y square whole square is nothing but what, y to the power of 4 by 2 minus y square whole cube is nothing but y power 6 by 3 into dy. Now here again you have to integrate. This is I am simplifying this first. Integral 0 to 1, 0 to 1, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 is nothing but LCM is 6, 3 minus 2 is nothing but 1 minus y power 4 by 2 minus half minus plus y power 6 by 3 into dy. Okay, now we have to integrate this one. Here you observe integral 1 by 6 is nothing but with respect to y by 6 minus y power 5 by 5 into 2 10 plus y power 7 by 7 times half 3 is nothing but 21. Now the lower limit of y is 0, upper limit of y is 1, and this is equal to, so upper limit if you are substituted, then 1 by 6 minus 1 by 10 plus 1 by 21 minus lower limit is 0 minus 0 plus 0. So if you simplified, then LCM for this is you will have a 210, and if you are simplified this, then you will have a 30, on simplifying you will have 24. 24 by 210 is nothing but 4 by 35 is the answer. Okay, thank you for watching this video.